In this tutorial, we're going to be talking a little bit more about OpenStreetMap. To see your OpenStreetMap base map, turn off the other layers, leaving OpenStreetMap on. Because it's open source, OpenStreetMap data can also be downloaded and added as vector data to our map. I am now going to show you how we can do this. Switch to your web browser and navigate to the Overpass Turbo website. There is a link in the video description. Zoom into your area of interest. Let's have a go at running a query of the OpenStreetMap data. Click the wizard button and type the word village into the search bar and click build and run query. You can see that all of the villages known in the OpenStreetMap data have been added to our map for our area. If we click the data button, we can see the details of each of these villages. We can do the same thing, for example, for roads. Or even restaurants. We can also find data that's useful to us as archaeologists. So click on the wizard button and type historic site and click build and run query. This may take some time depending on the size of your area. We can see that a number of historic sites have been marked in my area of interest. To export this data and add it to QGIS, we just need to click the export button. There are a number of different options, but we're going to save our data as a GeoJSON, which is similar to a shapefile. So click download, and then either save your data in your GIS folder or move it from your downloads folder into your GIS folder. Switch back to QGIS. And in order to add the data, click the Open Data Source Manager button. Click Vector and click the Browse button. We can see that here is our new GeoJSON file. However, in GIS it is always very important to organize and name your files well. So first we're going to rename this as Historic Sites. So right click it and click Rename and type Historic Sites. To make it more organized, we're also going to put it in its own OpenStreetMap folder. So click New Folder and type OpenStreetMap. And then drag your Historic Sites GeoJSON file into your OpenStreetMap folder. And double click the file and click Open. Click the Add button. The GeoJSON file contains both point and polygon features, so to add them both to our project, click Select All and OK. Then click Close. Right-click one of your files and click Zoom to Layer. we can see that all this historic site data has been added to QGIS. And if we zoom in, for example, there's a fort in the village of Wabil. Other data as well as geometry has been downloaded from OpenStreetMap. To see this, right-click one of your new files and click Open Attribute Table. You'll see that extra information has also been downloaded, including the type of historic site and the name of the historic site. To make the attribute table easier to see, we can dock it beneath the map view window. To do this, click the Dock Attribute Table button. We can change the size of it if we want. We can now work with this data as if it came from the database or as if we collected it ourselves with GPS. For instance, we can give each type of historic site a different color. I'm going to turn on Google Earth to make this more clear. Right-click your historic site's point file and click Properties. Click on the Symbology tab and change Single Symbol to Categorized. Change Value to Historic. And then click Classify. You will see that each different type of historic site has been given its own color. Click Apply and OK. And you'll see that these colors have been changed on the map. We can also add labels to the site using the name data. To do this, right-click your historic sites file and click Properties. Click on the Labels tab and change No Labels to Single Labels. Select Name in the drop-down menu and then select Buffer and tick Draw Text Buffer. Click Apply and OK. And you'll see that the names of these sites have been added to our map. Don't forget to save your work by clicking the Save button. Religious buildings are often not included in OpenStreetMap historic sites, but many of them are old and are of interest to archaeologists. To find these on the Overpass Turbo website, click Wizard and type Place of Worship and click Build and Run Query. Have a go at exporting these and adding these to your QGIS map.